the name is coming back like he said. I believe this trumpet's gonna sound so loud one day, it'll wake the dead in the twinkling of an eye. He'll split the eastern sky. I believe he's coming back by himself.
Like he
angels never knew the joy that is mine. For the blood has never washed their sins away. Though they say in heaven there will come a time when silently
Scripture, and is found tonight in John's Gospel, the third chapter. And I'm going to read the first seven verses of that passage of Scripture. And it says, "There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. This man came to Jesus by night and said to him, 'Rabbi, we know that you're a teacher from God, for no one can do these signs that you do unless God is with him.' Jesus answered and said to him, 'Most assuredly, I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God.' Nicodemus said to him, 'How can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born?' And Jesus answered, 'Most assuredly, I say to you, unless one is born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Do not marvel that I said to you, you must be born again. Praise God. Very familiar scriptures. And this evening, for a little while, I want to speak on a topic entitled The World's Greatest Tragedy. The World's Greatest Tragedy. And we have, praise God, been hit by many storms in our world, no doubt about it. We've been hit by earthquakes and storms and tsunamis and great natural tragedies that have made us very much on edge and filled with great fear and dread. It's made our lives less than a pleasure trip across the harbor. Praise God. For the past 18 or 19 months, COVID-19 has caused a lot of distress, loneliness, stress and financial hardship. And can I tell you, there is a greater tragedy still to come. Amen? I'm talking about the spiritual tragedy of a lost soul. That's what I'm talking about tonight. Nicodemus was a good man. He was a Pharisee, the Bible tells us, a very religious man who practiced his beliefs. He followed the traditions of men. He was a ruler of the Jews and a member of the Sanhedrin and one of the three richest men in all of Jerusalem. Praise God. He believed that Jesus was a good teacher. He believed that Jesus was only a teacher. Amen? He didn't believe that Jesus was the Savior. Amen? And a lot of people in our world today believes that Jesus was just somebody who came on the scene years ago, but they can't be saved through, praise God, through His Word and so on. Praise the Lord. He was spiritually blind. That was the problem with Nicodemus. He was the best that religion and education and culture could produce. Amen? Yet he knew nothing about spiritual birth or becoming a new creation or being born again, praise God, to be a Christian. Folks, the truth is many people today are taken up with tragedy and sickness, praise God, but they have never done anything about the sin issue that has separated them from God. That's the reality that we're facing. When Jesus brought up the issue of new birth, praise God, in verse number 3, Nicodemus's question was, how can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? And the answer to that is no, he can't. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. All Nicodemus could think about was the natural birth. Amen? Praise God. When Jesus was referring to spiritual birth, there's a lot of difference in natural birth and spiritual birth. Nicodemus was a good man. He was an educated man, but praise God, he didn't know anything about salvation or how to get saved. Praise God. Jesus made it clear to him that he was referring to a spiritual birth, not a physical birth. To be born again means to have a change happen inside of the human body. Praise the Lord. This change takes place in the heart. Praise God. We have to have a change of heart to have a changed life. Amen. When Jesus spoke to Nicodemus about the water and the Spirit, he thought about John the Baptist. He thought about John the Baptist, which was the baptism of repentance known back in those days. Jesus was talking about spiritual baptism. Praise the Lord. This, I believe, may refer, praise God, to the burial of the old man. Praise God. The whole you. The whole me. Praise the Lord. He is talking about regeneration. Praise God. Which means being born anew or to be born again. This is a change on the inside of a person. It happens on the inside of a person. It means giving control of your life over to someone else. Giving the driver's will to a better driver, in other words. A driver that will get us to the right destination. Praise God. Hallelujah. Nicodemus and Jesus were talking in terms of two different worlds. Praise God. Two different destinies. Nicodemus saw a birth as a reproduction after its kind, mankind, or whatever. All Nicodemus could think about was the fleshly birth, praise God. Life in the flesh, in other words. Jesus was referring to a new birth, a spiritual awakening, a change of heart, saying goodbye, praise the Lord, to the old man, praise God, the natural man, and taking on the newness of life, praise the Lord, the spiritual man. Nicodemus was thinking in terms of life here and now, praise God. Jesus was thinking in terms of the hereafter, praise God. Jesus was talking about, praise God, reservations for a trip. Amen. Praise God. From the earthly realm to the heavenly realm. That's what he was talking about. Jesus was plainly telling Nicodemus, there is more to living than the life you live here. Praise God. If you want to go to heaven, you have to have a change of heart. Praise God. You have to forsake your sin and live the changed life here while you still live on this earth. Praise God. Hallelujah. If not, you cannot have a heavenly life. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When you pass from this life here on this earth, there is eternal life, praise God, in the future. Amen. The soul will never die. Remember that. The soul will never die. Praise God. The soul will still live on, praise God, all through the countless ages of eternity. But it depends on if you're saved or not, where you will spend eternity. There, the Bible specifically says there is only two places. It's heaven or hell for you and me. That's the reality of the gospel. Praise God. Jesus wants all people everywhere to be saved. Amen? He wants everyone to go to heaven. Everyone. Praise the Lord. Now there's a miracle I want you to see tonight. Praise God. A miracle. Praise God. A minister was seeking to reach the heart of a dying doctor. The minister had spoken to him about conversion, about forgiveness of sin, about redemption, and all of the different themes of the Christian gospel. Then he spoke to him about regeneration, praise God, of the need to be reborn, and an enlightened the man's heart. The man had a change of heart when he heard that he could be reborn. Amen. Praise God. Over many years, the doctor had attended countless births. Amen. The new birth, he explained, praise God, why that's what I need. Praise God. That's what I need is the new birth. A baby has no past. Amen. Right? A baby has no past. All a baby has is a future. Praise God. Hallelujah. That's why, or that's what I need, he said. And so do we all. We need the new birth. We need to humble ourselves, praise God, like a little baby. We need to humble ourselves and seek the face of God. And ask God to take control. Amen. Praise the Lord. That's what happens when we get saved. Our sins are washed away. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They're cast into the sea of His forgetfulness. Praise God. Never to be remembered against us anymore forever. Our past is covered by the blood. And all we have is the future. Praise God. Church people, listen to me. You may think that you need a lot of things on this earth. You probably think you need a good, large bank account. Perhaps a beautiful home, maybe even the new home. The big cars, the big trucks, the new boats, and all of that sort of thing. All the other ties that we all crave for. Praise God. We make sure we store up and enjoy the now life, don't we? We make sure we store up and enjoy, praise God, all of the goodness that money can give us, praise God. But the world has not seen anything yet, praise the Lord. COVID is only a little thing. That's all it is, a little thing. Church being lost without Jesus is the world's greatest tragedy. We will all need Jesus at the crossing of the Jordan. Every last one of us. Folks, it's time to call Jesus. You've probably called a lot of people, but it's time to call on Jesus and ask Jesus to come into your heart and into your life. You need to ask His forgiveness. Praise God. Hallelujah. Can I tell you, there are a lot of religious people in our world. They believe in God as God Emmanuel. Amen? God with us. They think God is with us, so we're okay. But church, according to what I read in the Bible tonight, praise God, and I've been studying for a long time, it's not enough for God to be God Emmanuel, God with us. Praise God. We need to invite Jesus into our hearts. And then Jesus becomes God in us. And the Bible specifically says, God in us, our hope of glory. Without the new birth tonight, without salvation, praise God, we're lost and undone without God. Amen. We need to invite Him in tonight. We can't put it off much longer, because I believe that soon and very soon the trumpet will sound, and He that shall come will come, and He will not tarry. We need to realize tonight, praise God, that it's not about religion. Praise God. Religion will get us nowhere. We've got to have a relationship with Jesus. Amen. We need to invite Him into our heart. That's the only way we can have a relationship with Him. And tonight my prayer is that all of you, that everybody who hears this word will realize how desperate they need the born-again experience. How desperate they need to be saved, because the hour is late. And what we must do quickly. My prayer is that you'll be saved, praise God, before the coming of Jesus. And His coming is even at the door tonight. I believe that. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let's bow just for a moment. Father, I thank You tonight for Your word. I thank You because Your word is forever settled in heaven. And heaven and earth will pass away, but You said it Yourself. My word will not pass away. I pray tonight, Jesus, that people in this area and people in the surrounding areas will come to a relationship with Jesus Christ. That they will invite You into their life, Lord God, before it's eternally too late. We ask those things in Jesus' name and for the glory of God. Amen and amen.
Amen.